Hi, I'm Tony Zinn, a product manager on the Dynamics 365 Virtual Agent for Customer Service team, and what I'd like to do in this short video is show you how you can use variables and expressions to create dynamic conversations based off of the responses that your user is saying to the bot. So in order to start, first go ahead and sign into your bot, and once we land on the homepage here, I'm going to go ahead and navigate over to the topics page. And go ahead and just create a new topic here so that we can play around with variables and expressions and see how they work to help me dynamically generate content. So let's go ahead and just say this is something like, let's say this is a scenario with a rental car agency. So rental car quote. And this is say, we can create a couple triggers here. So we can say rental car quote, we can say looking for a price on a rental. And for the purposes of this demonstration, I think that's enough. So let's go ahead and just start with that. Now in this dialogue, let's say I want to create something very simple, which is to check the age of the person and then give them a different price depending on if they're over or under 25. This is a pretty common scenario with a number of different rental car agencies. So first I might start off by saying, how old are you? And what I want to do now is I want to be able to save this response for later to use in my expression as well as to dynamically generate content. So the way I do this is I select the user says, and here I can now provide some options here. Now, since I'm asking for an age, I actually want a number. So I'm going to delete this user response here and click on add variable. And now I can create something like user age. This type is actually not a text type. It can be an age type. And so let me go ahead and select that. And now I have an option here to basically create additional branches depending on the user response. So let's zoom out here to give myself a little bit more space to work with. And so I can select, let's say it's less than 25. Then I want to go down one path. And if it's more than 25, I actually want to go down a different path. So I can click on the plus sign and add another expression. And in this case, let me go ahead and pick user age again. And this time I want to say greater than or equal to 25, and I will go down this other path. Now again, part of what I can do with this product is even before I finish authoring all the content, I can test it out as I'm still working on the content itself. So let me just say you entered user age. And so if I click on this variable expression here, I can add that in and I can dynamically generate that content. And the price will unfortunately be higher, right? And then it can say, you will get the cheapest price because you entered in an age of, and we can again select the same variable here. So now even before I try anything else, let's go ahead and save this and just see if it works properly. And so let me turn on tracing here. I will start with the latest content. And now let me go ahead and try to trigger this. So you can say, I'm looking for a quote on a rental car. So this should now start to trigger. And you can see it now has triggered the dialogue that I just created. And it's now asking me how old I am. So at this point, let me try out something like, let's say I say I'm only 22. I would expect this to go down the left branch, which is the less than 25 branch. And after processing for a second here, you can see that it actually does do that as well. So let's go ahead and start over and try that again. I can say, looking for a quote on a car rental. This time, let's try the other branch just to make sure we've got that logic working properly. So as this dialogue triggers, I can now try the threshold number of 25, and this should go down the right branch, and we can see that it does. So of course, I can always create a much more complex variant of this as well, but you can see this is how you can start to use variables and expressions to create different paths and different branching options for your user to go down, as well as to use embedded variables within the bot says node to then generate dynamic content as your end user answers questions from the virtual agent. So I hope that was helpful, and thank you very much for watching this video.